I'm Xuan, I'm a gRPC maintainer, and I spend a lot of time on gRPC Python bindings. In this talk, I'll discuss gRPC Keepalive, a mechanism for maintaining active connections between clients and servers. We'll cover what Keepalive is, when to use it, and how to configure it effectively. Let's start with basics. What is Keepalive? Keepalive is a mechanism used in network protocols to maintain an active connection between the client and the server. For example, TCP level proxies, residential routers, and NATs may be configured to disconnect idle connections. Google Cloud load balancers disconnect idle connections after 10 minutes, and some other cloud providers may disconnect after 60 seconds. In those cases, Keepalive can be used to prevent connection timeouts and closures, and thus helps with reliability. How does gRPC Keepalive work? You might have heard of TCP Keepalive, which is configured on a per-socket basis. It's disabled by default, but when enabled, after an implementation-specific duration of inactivity, it will begin sending redundant packets waiting for their ACT. If no ACT is received after repeated attempts, the connection is deemed broken. This configuration is provided by the operational system and not exposed to higher-level APIs. Instead of TCP, gRPC uses HTTP2 PIN-based Keepalives. gRPC is built on top of HTTP2, which provides a PIN frame that causes the receiver to immediately reply with a PIN ACT. This PIN frame can be used for multiple purposes, like estimating round-trip time, testing bandwidth delay, or testing the connection itself. Using PIN frame gives us more flexibility, since gRPC implementations have tight control of the HTTP2 stack. Using PIN-based Keepalive also provides the ability for individual applications to configure more related settings. Now we know what Keepalive is and how it works in gRPC, when should we use it? As previously mentioned, you can use Keepalive when sending data over a long-lived connection, which may be considered idle by proxies or load balancers. It's also useful for less reliable networks, especially in mobile environments with poor network connectivity. Even with reliable network, Keepalive can be used to detect if client-server or even the network itself went down. Keepalive is a nice thing to have, but there are a few things you need to keep in mind when using Keepalive. First, service owners aren't required to support Keepalive. If you are writing client applications, you need to coordinate with service owners on whether a particular client-side setting is acceptable. It's up to service owners to decide what they are willing to support, including whether they are willing to receive Keepalive at all. Although a particular Keepalive is small and trivial to respond to, if you have a million clients sending a ping every 10 seconds, that will become 100,000 QPS for low work. Thus, it's recommended to avoid enabling Keepalive without cost and for clients to avoid configuring Keepalive much below 1 minute. This is also a way to prevent you be treated as a potential DOS attacking client. Now, let's dive into configuration itself. We have three basic parameters to configure gRPC Keepalive. First is Keepalive time. This controls the amount of time without having received data before PIN is sent. Second is Keepalive timeout, which is the timeout waiting for PIN frame to be acknowledged. Last one is Keepalive without cost. This is a boolean which controls if it's permissible to send pins without outstanding RPCs. You may be thinking that Keepalive is too complex for you to use it. You can rest assured that gRPC will take care of it for you. gRPC will set a reasonable default value for all Keepalive parameters. On the client side, Keepalive is disabled by default, and server will set Keepalive time to 2 hours to maintain the connection with client. The default Keepalive timeout is 20 seconds on both the client and the server. Lastly, Keepalive without cost is also disabled by default for both clients and servers. We don't recommend enabling this unless you know what you are doing. Let's assume you are very familiar on networking and you need to fine-tune Keepalive settings. What should you do? It's very easy to do it. Here's an example in Python. Keepalive is configured using channel options in Python clients. In this example, we are setting the Keepalive interval to 45 seconds with a 20 seconds timeout. We also enabled Keepalive without calls by setting the value to 1. Then we simply pass those options to the channel, and gRPC will make sure all RPCs to the channel will use those options. Please note that applications should ensure Keepalive timeout is higher than round trip time of the request by at least 2 or 3 times to allow for lost packets and TCP retransmits. It may also need to be higher to account for long garbage collector pauses. Again, we have reasonable defaults for all those options, so changing the defaults is not generally recommended. On the server side, Keepalive is controlled using server options. Similar to the client, creating the option and passing them to server constructor is all you need to do. Here, we are setting the Keepalive time to 5 minutes with a 10 seconds timeout. The Keepalive time varies, may seem a bit long, but it's recommended that you be conservative on server-side settings. Again, setting Keepalive permit without calls is not generally needed. That's all for today. You can find more information about gRPC on the website, GitHub repo, YouTube channel, and mailing list. Feel free to reach out if you have any questions. Thanks for watching.